The views and opinions expressed in the following program are not and do not represent the views and opinions of ZNBC.
Nifuna wose ali pano. Anyuzeko, ni upande wanji wa mene Panji Kaunda anaye mapo kuimira abantu muna muziko la Zambia.
Michael Chilufya Sata, whom I now simply refer to as Cobra, speaking at a campaign rally sometime in the 1990s to drum up support for Regina Piri, a candidate for the ruling Movement for Multi-Party Democracy, MMD, at the time in the Chadiza parliamentary by-election. Lieutenant Colonel Panji Kaunda, son of First Republican President Kenneth Kaunda, was aspiring for the same seat on the just-defeated United National Independence Party, UNIP. Panji is right now involved in a serious scheme with Namakando's Post, the Cobra's Patriotic Front, and some other prominent individuals and non-governmental civil society organizations to see to it that Rupia Banda and the ruling MMD do not continue running the affairs of government. He has actually endorsed the Cobra as his preferred 2011 presidential candidate. Panji, a Sandhurst-trained commissioned officer, is really on the loose, but it seems apparent that he still has not come to terms with the end of the 27 years of glory in State House, because 20 years on, he appears to be in denial. Yes, 27 years of glory and 20 years in denial. Panji's preferred presidential candidate, the Cobra, in his usual foul style, said a lot of things at the Chadiza rally against the person that has now come out in support of the serpent. I will leave it as raw as I got it from the archives so that you may judge for yourself the kind of person the Cobra is.
Muntu, wame naribe mutundu, si mutundu wachi chewa, si mutundu wachi nsenga, si mutundu wachi wemba, anga zile muamba wachi wemba. Manje usogule ya Panji aucho sapati. Usogule ili aucho sapati chifuka sana karipo wa section. Usogule ili si ufumu. Usogule ili si ufumu. Ya kuti mwana achokapo, tate achokapo, tulikepo mwana ai. Nga Panji wajawala karebwana mdala, nga kwa nisa uimkazu. Kwa hapo nisa wansi panupa platform. Asa wawo nisa tibwana machitako chani kudu kuchatisa 27 years. Zabile tifuna kuti mtipase muntu. Kwa kuti polo wa Moses Mwanga, alipe manyaza, alipe manta, alo banyada. Nga timwanipasa Panji, mzakala nae Panji, 5 years asa wawo Moses Mwanga. Zayambo kumana nae mnyumba ya mala muno kwa sila ulopo wana wa hile tulai nao kuja mawana apwela munga apwela kumkondo na majombo wose mliaba mni ujeko mwuzi wa Panji mchadiza ulikuti mfumu ya Panji mchadiza ulikuti ambuya wa Panji mchadiza ulikuti kodi za kudala za masiku onse za kudunabati na kuchinsari za sila.
Panji's support for the Cobra is his democratic right, but some of his comments against Rupia's administration have of late been way too much. In another edition, I will delve a little bit more into why Panji may have taken the path he has. But as for the Cobra, Panji's and Namakando's preferred presidential candidate, it is very clear that this serpent is extremely under pressure. He is doing all he can to feature on every radio station. But what is also very clear is that callers are now beginning to question his character. On Monday, 4th April 2011, the Cobra featured on a special phone-in program on Lusaka's QFM radio to together with the Bishop Edward Chomba and Munali Member of Parliament Mumbi Piri.
You're through to QFM. Good morning.
Good morning, Lakers.
Morning is fantastic. Who am I talking to?
Mchindo on the line.
Mr. Mchindo, let's be civilized this time.
Thank you. Mike, good morning.
Kamambe wa Mchindo.
Thank you. Good morning, the other pastor there.
Good morning, my brother. Bishop Chomba here.
I'm starting with you, Bishop Chomba.
Yes.
You see, first of all, you have disturbed the nation. Being a bishop, the language you are using there is not a good language. You cannot call Emmanuel Mwemba. At the time when Chiruba was supporting PF, you were very, very, very a good friend with him. Now calling Emmanuel Mwemba, Kanshi, Kaisa, Nakalufu Mokakwe, that it erodes or whatever you have as a bishop. Coming to Mr. Mike. Mike, are you not ashamed for yourself? The same people you fired when you were a minister without a portfolio at UTH, the same doctors, when you were thrown to South Africa, these are the same people who resuscitated you.
Can you name one doctor?
You don't know.
I know them.
Yes, you found
don't lie.
Mr. Sata, let me handle this. Mr. Mchindo
is a liar.
Can I handle this, please? Mr. Mchindo, can we talk about issues, really?
You are based on.
I've told you this several times, and next time you'll be calling and I catch you off, do not complain. Let's look at the issues we are discussing. You are beginning to go to issues that are absolutely irrelevant. Let's discuss issues. Okay, we are not understanding each other, Mr. Mchindo. Thank you very much.
The Cobra, in his usual hysterical way, became defensive even before the caller, a Mr. Mchindo, could finish his contribution. And as it turned out to be, the caller, who happens to be a regular contributor to phone-in programs on QFM, was curtailed by the presenter. But the program went on.
Kasambo Imano is my name.
Your name again, sir?
Kasambo Imano.
Mr. Kasambo, great having you on the show. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, Bishop, and good morning, Mr. Sata.
Good morning, Mr. Kasambo.
I have a slight problem with what the Bishop was saying. And my problem is based on Zambia being a Christian nation. When Dr. Chiruba declared Zambia a Christian nation, where were you? For you to come over 10 years later that we should debate. Because you had a problem with Dr. Chiruba, you should not come and talk about Zambia being a Christian nation because of your personal problem. Yes, Dr. Chiruba was wrong in whatever I did, but do not bring in Zambia being a Christian nation in the picture. It has nothing to do with the way Chiruba is standing. We know how he's living, but it has nothing to do with him. Forget about him, deal with him in his personal capacity, and leave Zambia for God. It does not matter how many people are living righteous lives. For us to compare that, we should debate. Please, sir, spare Zambia for God. Whatever differences, when Zambia was declared a Christian nation in 1996, these things that are happening now, where are they then? Where are you? Please, I beg you, sir, let us not debate. Let us leave Zambia for God and for some of us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for coming through. Appreciate your call. You're through to QFM. Good morning.
Thank you. How are you, sir?
I'm great. Who are we talking to, sir?
You are talking to James Mwenda.
Well, your call is appreciated on the show. Go ahead.
Thank you. Bishop, how are you?
I'm very well, my brother. Good morning.
Mr. Sata, how are you?
You are James Ukalipo.
I'm around, thank you.
Very good. I haven't seen you for a long time. Sione kaone kama siku wano.
No, I'm around, Bishop. Oh. I'm around, Mr. Sata, yeah.
Okay, mana.
I have a concern, one, with the personal attack the Bishop is trying to portray on the former head of state. One of the things that the bishop himself knows and what is biblical is we should respect the authority that has been and the authority that is in power. And if the bishop can come out like that trying to influence change on issues that himself can dialogue and seek audience with the authority, and he comes on the media trying to show that he has it all, I think I have a problem as a Christian on issues that the bishop is trying to raise. One of the things that we as Christians should do is to seek dialogue and advice where we can, rather than going to the media and try to outburst and speak that we know it all. And speaking like you cannot forgive is so sad of a bishop of his statue and the way you've called yourself to be. Christianity is all about forgiveness. Christianity is all about respect. Christianity is all about dialogue. And I'm one of the Christians that, I am a Christian. And I think there's literally nothing wrong with the former head of state, Dr. Chiruba, to declare Zambia as a Christian nation. The declaration was made and passed as Zambia as a Christian nation. All what remains is for us as Zambians now to improve and implement on our declaration as a Christian nation. That is what is called by the Bible. And two, a
Bible in which chapter?
Just a minute, Mr. Sata.
No, just let him finish.
And two, the bishop to start attacking the authorities. When the Bible says authority, then we should respect the authority. And then a person who really respects the premise of the Bible, start attacking the authority in power, I think it's not good for a bishop to try and champion his own agenda. So what I would rather seek to talk to the bishop is about, maybe you haven't been in Zambia for some time. One of the things that I can advise and tell you is, including Mr. Sata himself, is we should appreciate where somebody has done something. Let us look at the good thing that RRB, Mr. Rupia Banda, has done. Mr. Sata was telling about road network just now. I was in Choma, where Mr. Rupia Banda has improved the issue of the road network, infrastructure in terms of school, infrastructure in terms of hospitals,
Which infrastructure in Choma? Which infrastructure in Choma? Tell us. Don't be like Chanda Chimba. Don't be like Chanda Chimba. Tell us.
Mr. Presenter, am I protected?
Yeah, yes, go ahead. Can you mention the names of the structures that you're referring to in Choma?
I'm coming there, Mr. Presenter.
Go ahead, and please make sure that you are quick. You've been on the line for a long time.
I should be protected first, Mr. Presenter.
Yes, you are protected. Go ahead.
And you are to protect the caller.
Go ahead.
Yes. What I'm saying is, let's talk about Namwala. Going down Choma. From Namwala first, you turn to Namwala going to, there's a road, RRB just, which he did, and he officiated on that road, I think it's almost 3-6 months ago.
Which particular road?
Let me come in.
I'm sure he's about to mention,
because Choma Namwala road, we know it, but which particular road?
Can we give him a chance? He's saying that.
But first of all,
which road? Okay, can you mention the names of the roads and the structures?
Am I protected, or maybe you're only protecting your clients on the radio?
My conclusion is that QFM did not do a good job to protect callers like Kasambo and Mwenda against the interjections of the Cobra, for it became all too clear that the role of moderator had also been hijacked by this serpent. But that is his very true nature, and that is why I have kept on telling my fellow Zambians that this serpent should never be allowed to be president of Zambia. Yes, the Cobra is trotting from one radio station to the other, even promising that he will give licenses he says will allow all radio stations infinite radius. So on Friday, 8th April 2011, the Cobra was on Radio Phoenix.
Right, let's go straight to our first caller. Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Hello, good afternoon.
Welcome to the program. Who is speaking?
Hello, Kenneth.
Hello?
Kenneth, who?
Kenneth Zulu.
Iwe Zulu. Ulipo iwe Zulu.
Where are you calling from, Mr. Zulu?
I'm calling from Ndola.
From Ndola. Okay. I hope you have been following the discussion with the president of the PM.
Zulu alichenjera sana.
Yes, Mr. Zulu, what's your contribution?
I'm from Chilemba.
Na mfe mchini nyanja kutuwa landaiwe Zulu na mchini senga.
Okay, Mr. Zulu, go ahead.
Hello?
Yeah, I was saying, go ahead, Mchipemba.
Mkwena, kwena, mwanapamu, pachualo, kwena, tata muli, mwabachi, kushu, kwewa, kushu, ni, ya muna, ni mwemu, ali mwemu, Hello, you want to go Parliament? Ala. Lelo, wampiri. No puti la yo. Avan si tawre pota constitution. Hello, kami ni pekshwa. Kasa tuwidi nu yufo.
Sorry, we have a problem with that line. Maybe it's our caller's line, which is...
No, it's Mr. Zulu. I've heard some of the things...
Maybe you've got an idea what he wants
no,
to
do. No, what is...
Sorry about that, Mr. Zulu. The line was cutting. I think it could be either the fault from his line. Yes, sir.
What Mr. Zulu is saying...
Yes.
He's saying an MMD slogan. That in 1996, we are saying Kaundara. You could not say 1996 Kaunda Rala because MMD came to power in 1991. So typical of MMD, they are very backwards, very, very backward. He says in 1996, Mareti, that's what Muchindu, you remember what that Muchindu said? Say where he said Michael Sata and Edith Nawakoya saying Kaunda Rala. Two, he is talking about this Chanda Chimba. In an interview of 1.5 hours, Chanda Chimba takes 44 seconds of this homosexual and say that's your voice. So you can hear from what Mr. Zulu is saying is a contaminated MMD. Sorry, Mr. Zulu, that everything you are saying is not true.
Let's try our next caller on the same line, 226841 or 226292. Hello, good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon.
You are welcome to the program. We're speaking.
Yes.
Who is speaking?
You call me Mr. X.
Mr. X, where are you calling from?
From Ndola.
From Ndola.
Mm.
Right.
Hello, Mr. X.
I'm quiet. But I'm a
Mr. X, thank you very much. Listen, first of all, you don't make laws which is not serving any purpose. You make a law to serve a purpose. What's the use of regularizing homosexual? Because Chanda Chimba only took 44 seconds. And even that 44 seconds which he took from a debate of 1.5 hours, there was nowhere I ever said I shall regularize.
He said it himself. And he said Zambian laws recognize gays and lesbians from his own foul mouth. It does not matter whether what I have picked from the conversation is 40, 42, or 44 seconds. What is true is that the Cobra said what he said, period. I have stated before that no amount of sugarcoating, public relations damage control will get the Cobra off the hook regarding what he said to the delegation from Denmark on gays and lesbians.
The laws of Zambia recognizes gays. The laws of Zambia recognizes lesbians. The laws are already there. What we need is to implement the laws.
We in UPND are against homosexuality. We in the UPND are against homosexuality. And it is extremely important that as a Christian nation, we understand that God made man and woman. And these two must live as partners. Now, our colleagues are promoting homosexuality. Maybe that's why they didn't want to talk about our programs, our policies. Maybe they wanted to sneak the homosexuality policy after forming government. Unfortunately, God is there and guided us, and now we are going to have a country without homosexuality from a leadership.
Zambia is a Christian nation, yeah. And our laws are tailored along Christian lines. From time immemorial, as Africans, we don't condone unnatural practices. What is described in the Penal Code as sodomy and having sexual intercourse against the order of nature. That is illegal in Zambia, and I know that there are some politicians who are trying to encourage our people to engage in such practices. Mr. Speaker, this is a very serious offense in Zambia. It carries a minimum sentence, I think, of 14 years imprisonment. Minimum sentence of 14 years imprisonment. And therefore, my advice to some of the political leaders, one or two presidents of political parties, is to give a good example, especially to our young people, that these foreign practices should not be encouraged in Zambia. We should not encourage criminality as leaders. And we should continue to live as Christians in this country. So that kind of those tendencies should be condemned in the strongest possible terms.
All the bad and negative elements quickly manifest in this Antichrist devil's child, who now proclaims himself as a Catholic fundamentalist, as if there are no other religious faiths in Zambia. That is why, just before the results of the 2008 presidential election were announced at Lusaka's Mulungushi International Conference Center, the Cobra held all sorts of abusive language against the media, particularly the British Broadcasting Corporation, BBC. It still appears up to this day that the Cobra had some amount of hatred against the BBC. The BBC reporter must have received an antidote to continue with his work, because the Cobra's venom on this day was terribly lethal.
I have not bloody lost, so don't waste my time. I have not lost. How do I accept the word I have not lost? You are the bloody reporter. Ask them. You are the so-called reporter wasting taxpayers' money here, and you have got these inflated figures on which they say they are closing in. These are fake reports. They were not there in 2006.
Have you spoken to them about these figures then?
I'm giving to you. Go and speak to them. I'm hunting for them. They have run away.
This bloody BBC, this is not Zimbabwe.
And they expect that BBC comes to me. What do you do? They think I'm in Zimbabwe. MMD has no stronghold. They are only a bunch of thieves. They are only a bunch of criminals.
The Cobra does not find anything wrong with calling anyone all sorts of names. Yet when he is referred to as a criminal, he wants to cry out loud like it is the end of the world. But what he must do in 2011 is be ready to be defeated by Rupia and the MMD, because whether he, Panji, Namakando's post and others like it or not, Rupia Bwezanibanda is a better candidate by far.
views and opinions expressed in the program were not and did not represent the views and opinions of ZNBC, but those of the producers.